very imbalanced personality. He will be very insecure, he will be very pessimistic, he will be aggressive or arrogant. And you know that if the mother is dominant, means the children of a dominant mother will be very passive, they will be lazy, they will be dependable, they will be quarrelsome. So the family atmosphere plays a vital role in the development of personality. Next come the cultural factors. After the social factors, the cultural factor plays an important role in the development of personality. What's the cultural factor? The culture of rural society and urban society. Totally different. So if it has been found from the research study that if a twin, you can say a twin, if one will be brought up in the urban area and another will be brought up in the rural area, they will have different personality. So here, not the physical factor, but the cultural factor plays the vital role. Because of the cultural differences, they have different personality. Otherwise, either they are the identical twin or fraternal twin, they inherit the same genes, but the difference is due to the effect of culture. Then the role of school is also very important. If the child is quite comfortable in the education system, he is comfortable with the teacher, with the siblings, with the peer group, the child have a very stable personality, he can adjust with every situation. But if a child cannot adjust in the school atmosphere, he will develop inferiority complex and he cannot adjust anywhere. Always you will feel very insecure. While you will be put in any situation, he cannot handle it properly. He needs somebody's support. So this was the cultural factor. So these factors, they affect the personality of a person. Now I will come to what are the measures we use to measure the personality. What are the methods we use to measure the personality? Usually those methods are divided into two categories or two groups. One is psychometric method. And another is, very good, projective method. Psychometric methods usually measure the surface stress, whereas the projective methods, they measure the source stress which are present within the person and they are not usually visible, but the surface stress are usually visible. So psychometric methods include different tests. They are case history method, paper pencil test, again divided into questionnaires and MMPR. Then rating scale, behavior test, and finally the interview. Case history method. Case history method is a method, as the name suggests, it takes the history of the subject, and subject is known as a case. And it is more useful when we have a psychopathic personality. Means there are some deviation in the personality of a person in a negative way. He cannot adjust with the situation, he has some problems, and at that time we want to know where the problem lies. So we take the help of case history method. Here we focus on various aspects of a person. His personal history, which is collected from the family members, the parents, the siblings, the relatives. Then the social history, it is collected by the help of the society, the neighbors,
the friend